Hey, what's up? Welcome to another Dolomite's Quick Edit video. As you can see, this time I'm working on a daytime shot and I want to show you a few nice tricks to get crispy clear and sharp daytime images using Lightroom. Also, I want to clean up the image a little bit, especially on the left side, getting rid of those houses and some of the cows and this path leading up the mountain, for which I will be using Photoshop. But first, here are the before and after images. So the biggest part of the editing will be done in Lightroom. First, let's check the lens corrections real quick. And then let's start the basic editing. For the profile, I'm going with Adobe Landscape, since this will boost the saturation quite a bit. And for this daytime shot, I want to have some nice boosted colors. For the moment, I don't want to change the white balance. I think this looks quite accurate this way. Next, I want to balance the exposure a bit. That means I'm dropping the highlights, especially to get some details in those white puffy clouds. And then I'm also slightly increasing the shadows. Now looking at the histogram, we have some room to the right. That means I can increase the whites without overexposing anything. Okay. Then I want to work on making this image a lot sharper and clearer. And for those kind of photos, it's pretty easy. First, I'm adding a little bit of texture and then also I'm increasing the clarity. Of course, I could add a lot more, but I want to further boost the texture and clarity using local adjustments to not overdo it. Then let's also add some vibrance real quick. And then head to the local adjustments. As you can see, I have applied two gradiated filters, one for the sky and one for the foreground. Let's work on this one first. So again, let's increase the clarity. And you will notice how the grass in the foreground looks much, much better by adding clarity. Then maybe let's also add a little bit of contrast. And to make it a bit darker, I'm dropping the exposure. Okay, then let's go to the sky real quick. And with this gradiated filter, I only want to affect the blue part of the sky. And that's why I have applied a color range mask. And with the eyedropper tool, I picked a color from the blue part of the sky, as you can see, and then adjusted the amount a little bit. So a brighter, similar color range will be affected by this gradiated filter. And once I have done this, I can simply drop the exposure and this will add some kind of polarization effect by making the blue part a lot darker. And since only the blue part is affected, where there isn't any structure to be found, I can also add a lot of noise reduction. And that's it for this one. Then I have also applied one radial filter for the center part of the image, just because I want to have some more structure in that mountain range. And again, I'm simply increasing the clarity and the texture. Okay, then maybe let's do a little bit of color grading. I think I want to boost the color tones of the field and the foreground, but instead of increasing the green color tones, I'm increasing the yellow saturation. And then I also want to boost the yellow luminance, making this area a bit brighter. Alright. For this shot, I'm skipping the split toning because I quite like the color look of this image. And I personally think split toning is more a thing for sunset and sunrise shots, but that's just my opinion. And of course, let's also sharpen the image. Okay, and that is basically the editing for this shot. Now, of course, on the left side of the image, there are many things going on and I want to clean it up a little bit. So I'm heading to Photoshop to clean up the image. Okay, and since there will be a lot of editing going on, I'm going to duplicate the layer in case I mess something up. And first, let's also get rid of the vignetting. So I'm just using the lasso tool to make a selection, hit Shift F5 with the content aware fill selected, Then do the same thing on the other side. Okay, next let's pick the spot healing brush and start cleaning up the image. So let's see. Since this is a rather big area to clean up, I'm starting with the smallest things I want to get rid of and work my way towards the bigger things like the house in the back you can see right there. Then let's try getting rid of this path. Now I think I want to keep the path leading up until this point, but the problem is, since I have removed a few cows from this area, the path suddenly stops here. I can fix that by grabbing the clone stem tool and copying an area from here and placing it next to the end of the path, and then just continue like this. Now there's a little repeating pattern on the path. I'm simply grabbing the spot healing brush to fix that. Alright, looks much cleaner now. And also, I think that's it for editing this daytime shot. So I hope this was a helpful and interesting video. If you have any questions or suggestions, then please let me know in the comments. And thank you very much for watching this video. Thank you.